This is a early 70s or mid 70s actually. HD28, let me get the serial number. 407. 407, so that puts it probably around, I don't know, you can look it up, 1976, 77, something around there. Anyway, for a while, Martin didn't make anything with a herringbone binding and scallop bracings, and in the mid-70s, they introduced the HD28, and that's what this is. And that was the first time in since the 30s that they'd had a scallop brace guitar. They, how to put this politely, they didn't know what they were doing back then, at least not as well as they do now. And so they scalloped these early HDs kind of funny. They scalloped them with a curve that's right here at the bridge point. So the maximum curve is right here. And almost every one of these that I've seen now, 40 years later, 30 years later, has got a pretty ferocious belly back here, because they put that the stress riser right there at the point of the bridge, rather than making a smooth scallop clear across the braces. If you look at a GE, for instance, a D18 GE or any of the authentics, now those are done pretty good, and you will find that the scallop starts at the X brace, right here at the X, and it goes smoothly back into a curve. And that's not what happens here. That's got a kind of a cookie cutter cut to it. So I get these in, and a lot of times my job is to try to control that belly. And that was the case on this guitar. It had just a monster belly that went right in between the X braces right here and just bulging forward like this. Somebody had shaved the bridge down. It needed a neck reset. It needed frets. It needed some other stuff. So I put a new bridge on it, and I used a thin bridge. One of the, you know, Martin comes in three different sizes of bridges. I used the thinner size in order to not put too much torque on that top. This top has so much bounce to it that I wanted to keep the tension off of it, keep that pull in a straight line and not over torque it and cause that belly to get worse. I watched it for a while, and it still had a nasty belly here, so I went hunting and I found a loose brace here. And it was loose on this side of the bridge plate, so if you're poking at it from the bridge plate, I didn't find it. But when I poked at it from this side, I found it. So I glued the brace up. It still was a little bit more belly than I would have liked to have done. So I used a spruce brace on the back side of the bridge. So kind of like what the PMTE is. And you can Google that term and find out what it is. But in this case, I used a spruce brace to make it really light and just to add a little bit of strength right across the back of the bridge right here to help load the force over to the X braces. And that helped. That helped a lot. Got the brace down, or got the belly down anyways. And this bulge right here is a lot less. It used to be just a sharp, oh, nasty bulge right there where it hit the X brace. It scared me. So I took care of that, did a neck reset on it, and I completely refretted it with gold Evo wire. And here's what it looks like. A lot of people ask us, does the gold clash with like silver tuners, for instance? And I don't really think so. I mean, you got to really look at it to even see the gold. And, you know, from a distance, you really can't tell. When I'm looking down at it here, I can see there's gold, but so are the strings, you know, so whatever. All right, I don't think I have any of these older HD28s on my video collection here, so I thought I'd record this one. And, you know, I've gone through the top issue, so if you're buying one, you might want to look for that. On the other hand, because the top is so soft, boy, it is a resonant beast. This thing, listen to this thing, it's like a drum. I mean, when I hit it like that, the whole guitar just shakes. It really has a percussion to it. And I could really feel that top vibrating. The whole guitar is just vibrating. That shows up in your rhythm playing, and you get this whomp, you get this percussion back here. You don't get that in a lot of guitars, a percussion effect, and it shows it's useful in your strum. Yeah, that whomp, the power, percussion, that is a great rhythm sound to me. Thank you. There we go, an HD28. Fun guitar. Should be in good shape now for another 20 years, maybe. I also put Bowden Bridge pins on them, but the owner commented that maybe it was getting, it lost a little treble. Well, yeah, that'll happen as it gets boomier. That's the reason I don't like to over scallop guitars when I do my own personal scalloping on 70s and stuff. I don't scallop even close to what this is, because I don't want it to, over time, I don't want it to lose the treble and the punch. I just want to open it up a little bit. And this is an example of one that is boomy. In a jam session or something, that's great. You get behind a microphone, especially on stage, and this can get uncontrollable. Especially if your volume has to come up a little bit, you'll get a lot of feedback with a guitar like this. In an acoustic situation, fun. But you know, then there's the belly. So I don't want that to happen to any of the ones I scallop. I don't scallop this much. I don't really want that sound. Unless you're willing to deal with the belly. So